Welcome back to my channel. In this video, we're going to be going over the relationship between figs and fig wasps. Fig wasps and fig plants have evolved a mutualistic relationship where fig wasps are responsible for pollination of the fig plant, whilst the fig fruit provides a place for the fig wasp eggs to be laid and develop. The fruit of figs are called synconia, or singular synconium. The synconium is actually an inflorescence made up of many flowers. It is also an accessory fruit, as some of the tissues of the fruit are made from tissues other than that from just the ovaries of the flower. The fruit consists of an enlarged and fleshy receptacle that is hollow on the inside. This receptacle is part of the fruit not made from the flower ovaries, and is instead made from a modified fleshy stem. The inside of this receptacle is lined by the small flowers of the fig plant. At the end of the synconium is an opening called the ostiole. The ostiole is lined with bracts. In some fig species, male and female flowers are found in fig fruits from separate plants. In others, such as in this example we are going to look at, both female and male flowers are found within the same fig. Each of these female flowers has only a single ovary. The life cycle of fig wasps is reliant on the fig fruit. Fig plants that don't self-fertilize are reliant on fig wasps for reproduction and the completion of their life cycle. The first step in this mutualism for the synconium is for the ostiole to open up a bit more at the time it is more receptive to pollen. The first step in this mutualism for the fig wasps is for a female fig wasp who already has pollen from another fig plant on it to enter the fig through the ostiole. The ostiole is tiny and aids in making the fig more pollinator specific. It often closes back up after the receptive period. The second step involves these female wasps moving over some of the female flowers, pollinating them. They do this as a byproduct of moving over the female flowers to lay their own eggs in the ovaries of some of these female flowers. These female wasps die shortly after laying their eggs. The third step involves the ovaries with wasp eggs in them forming gall-like structures. The fig wasp larvae grow in these galls. The female flowers that got pollinated form seeds within the ovaries. The fourth step involves new male fig wasps emerging from the fig. This male wasp moves around to fertilize the female wasps while they are still in the galls. Once they mate with the females, they dig escape tunnels for the female to use to escape the fig fruit. They then die. The fifth step involves the male flowers maturing and the female fig wasps emerging from their galls. The female wasps collect the pollen from these male flowers by moving over them towards the escape tunnels. The sixth and final step involves the mated females leaving through the escape tunnels, taking the fig pollen with them. They then fly to another fig tree and the cycle continues. And that concludes this video on the relationship between figs and fig wasps. Thank you for watching. If you want to support this channel, please subscribe and check out more of my videos.